What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. In today's video, we're going to look at 10 false friends. As you know, there are plenty of them in English, and I think it's time there was one English Beat with some false friends. Are you ready? So let's get into it. So false friends are English words that look very similar to words in Spanish, but have a very different meaning. Let me introduce to you the first false friend, which is sensible. In English, this word doesn't mean sensible, but sensato. And if we want to say sensible in English, it would be sensitive. For example, I'm sure you've made a sensible decision, which means decisión sensata, not sensible. Now let's move on to our second false friend, which is terrific. In English, it doesn't mean terrorífico, but great or very good. Increíble o estupendo. And if we want to say terrorífico, in English, it would be terrifying. For example, the movie is terrific. Now let's look at our false friend number 3, which is constipated. It doesn't mean constipado, be very careful. It has a completely different meaning, which is estreñido. And if you want to say constipado, it would be to have a cold. For example, you should eat more fiber in order not to get constipated. Now let's move on to our false friend number 4, which is blunt. It's level C2, and in English it doesn't mean blando, but xoxo o aburrido. And if we want to say blando, it would be soft. For example, I didn't enjoy the food as it was bland. Or another example, I find his new song rather bland. Now let's look at another false friend, which is actually. In English, it doesn't mean actualmente, but realmente. And if we want to say actualmente, we can say nowadays, currently, or in the present. For example, the detective is trying to find out what actually happened. Now let's move on to our false friend number 6, which is to pretend. In English, it doesn't mean pretender, but fingir. If you want to say pretender, it would be to expect. For example, he pretended to be ill, so he didn't have to go to work. Our false friend number 7 is to assist. It doesn't mean asistir, but ayudar. If you want to say asistir, it would be to attend. For example, her job is to assist the boss. Now let's move on to our false friend number 8, which is to resume, level C1. In English, this word doesn't mean resumir, but reanudar. If we want to say resumir, it would be to summarize. For example, the class will resume after a 10-minute break. Okay, now let's look at our false friend number 9, which is conductor. In English, it doesn't mean conductor, but it can be o director de orquesta o revisor. If you want to say conductor, it would be driver. For example, he's an extremely talented conductor. And last but not least, the word fabric, which is level C1. In English, it doesn't mean fabrica, but tela. Fabrica would be factory. For example, I like this dress fabric. So I hope you liked my first selection of false friends. If you want me to make another video with more, just let me know in the comments below. And of course, if you enjoyed this English Beat, don't forget to like it, to subscribe to the channel, and it would be really nice if you could share this video with your friends. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Don't be late. Ciao!